While 70 million soldiers are fighting on the front lines, territories occupied by the Central Powers are under strict military rule that is supposed to stifle any resistance among locals.
Na okupiranim teritorijama Belgije, Francuske i Carske Rusije stanovništvo je bilo pokoreno i pokorno. Ali ne i u Srbiji. Samo u Srbiji, u Toplici, podignut je masovni narodni ustanak i vođena organizovana gerilska borba protiv centralnih sila. Ovo je priča o tome.
Autumn of 1915, attacked by more than 500,000 German, Austro-Hungarian and Bulgarian troops, the entire territory of the Kingdom of Serbia was occupied. By the end of December, the Serbian army had withdrawn through Montenegro and Albania to the Adriatic coast in order to connect with the Allies. Serbian territory was divided into two occupation zones, Austro-Hungarian and Bulgarian, while the German army managed railway communications in the Morava and Vardar valleys.
Austro-Ugarske okupacione snage nastoje da narod odvrate od ideje slobode, slome nacionalnu svest i nadu o sopstvenoj državi i privole ga na život u monarhiji. Istovremeno, Bugari svoje osvajačke pretenzije zasnivaju na ideji da Srbi koji žive u Toplici i celoj južnoj Srbiji nisu Srbi, nego Moravski Bugari.
It was therefore necessary to implement a complete Bulgarization to erase any mention of Serbian names. The first victims were the intelligentsia, clergy and prominent citizens.
Srpska imena pretvarana su u bugarska uz izdavanje bugarskih dokumenata i uz zabranu svake komunikacije na srpskom jeziku. Spaljivane su srpske knjige, rušeni spomenici na grobljima, a matične knjige i spiskovi stanovništva odnošeni su u Sofiju.
Serbian national clothing and folk hats were prohibited. Bulgarian education was introduced in the schools. Since all this did not produce the results expected, the occupying forces resorted to sheer physical violence, the destruction of homes and property, and even torture and mass murder of the population. With the male part of the population in Serbia halved, women began to represent a special kind of problem for the enemy. The Bulgarians saw them as the guardians of Serbian tradition. Therefore, the official instructions for Bulgarization in the Morava military district stated that Serbian women were the most important and the most eager chauvinists, and, as bearers of the Serbian national spirit, they must be subdued.
Za ljude koji su odvođeni iz svojih mesta, govorilo se da su otišli u Sofiju, što u jeziku Južne Srbije postaje sinonim za nestanak iz sveta prisutnih i često iz sveta živih.
In the spring of 1916, the commotion among the people was a common subject in the occupation forces headquarters. It was known that guerrilla units had been formed in the area of Toplica and Jablanica and on the slopes of Kopalnik and Jastrebac. These troops were composed of soldiers, most of them wounded or left behind during the withdrawal of the Serbian army, as well as South Serbian civilians who collectively or individually went to the forests. Komita units, poorly armed and equipped, made armed assaults against the Austro-Hungarian and Bulgarian units. Sudden attacks from the forests and the mountain were a constant threat and caused fear within the superior enemy units, weakening and undermining their combat ability.
Sa pojavom komitskih četa, pojačava se i neprijateljski teror, u narodu počinje da vri.
With his courage and military skills, Kosta Vojinović Kosovac was beginning to stand out as a leader. At the same time, Serbian Supreme Command Intelligence Department decided to send into the occupied country an able army officer who would organize and prepare Chetnik units for combat sabotage activities. Kostas Milovanović Pečanac was chosen for this mission, and at the end of September of 1916, he was transferred to Mehana village near Kuršumlija by a French plane from the Salonika front.
Odluka srpske vrhovne komande da se u okupirano područje Toplice u jesen 1916. godine ubaci Kostas Milovanović Pečanac bila je na tragu smernica iz doktrina za četničko i gerilsko ratovanje koje je u srpskoj vojsci postojalo još od sredine 19. veka.
In November, after the two namesakes met, the Komita unit was unified. Vojinović remains a central figure who succeeded and was loved. But it was agreed that Pečanac, as a representative of the Supreme Command and as the senior, should be in command. The main question was asked, when should the uprising start? Supreme Command's directive was to store the weapons and wait for the front lines to come near. But in February 1917, the Bulgarians started the forced recruitment of Serbian men into the Bulgarian army. The uprising erupted in force and developed into overall resistance and national armed struggle.
Već je tokom 1916. godine kroz narod prostrujala vest da se Bugari spremaju da mobilišu srpske mladiće u svoju vojsku. Kad je ta glasina u toku zime potvrđena dolaskom komisija, regrutnih komisija na teren, to je bio u jednom trenutku pravi okidač za razvoj tog masovnog ustanka protiv okupatora.
Od samog početka Kosta Vojinović i Kosta Pećanac mimoilazili su se u dogovorima, a najviše oko pravog vremena za izbijanje ustanka. Pećanac je sledio uputstva vrhovne komande. Narod naoružavati i pripremati za borbu, ali tajno. I napad na neprijatelja početi kada sa fronta stigne signal za izbijanje ustanka. Sa druge strane, Kosta Vojinović slušao je glas namučenog naroda. Ustanak i to odmah.
Ja velim, braćo, da nije vreme za ustanak. Ne dižite pobune kad im vreme nije. Izginut ćete. Narod će stradati. Sačekajte da stigne čas.
Vesti stižu sa svih strana. Niko neće na regrutaciju niti u internaciju. Narod se okiti oružjem i traži borbu.
Evo ih ljudi, pa ih pitajte.
Narod je već krenuo.
Ovo u drugom pravcu ne može. Te vam ja kažem, braćo, na ustanak. Sretna sloboda!
Sretna sloboda!
Sretna sloboda!
Sretna sloboda!
Sretna sloboda!
For the occupying forces, the beginning of the uprising was sudden and fierce. A Bulgarian posse, which was chasing runaway Serbian boys, was defeated near the village of Bojnik on February 24, 1917. Insurgents liberated Kuršumlija on February 28th, and by March 5th, Lebane, Prokuplje and Blace were liberated. The people flocked to the Komita units. It is assumed that in the area of Pusta Reka, Toplica, Jablanica and the surrounding areas, about 13,000 people took up arms. The successes of the rebels were significant, within a radius of some 80 kilometers. Folk troops, without outside help, inflicting losses upon two regular armies, created a free territory, forcing occupation forces to retreat. Units which did not withdraw surrendered. In Prokuplje alone, some 800 Bulgarian soldiers were captured. The strength, courage, and success of the insurgents instilled fear. The plea for reinforcements was almost frantic. In Niš, an important communications hub, as well as Bulgarians, additional German forces were urgently deployed. The uprising was becoming a serious threat for the Central Powers' war effort, and it urgently needed to be neutralized.
Za uspeh ustanka od najveće važnosti bilo je jedinstvo među ustaničkim vođama, ali neslaganja su i dalje bila prisutna. U borbama za Prokuplje Pećanac je naredio da se grad samo opkoli i da se sačeka dok on ne stigne lično, uz pretnju da će ubiti onoga ko prekrši naređenje. Ali u zoru 1. marta borbe su otpočele bez Pećanca. Bugari su uveliko bili odbijeni sa oboda grada i povukli su se u zgradu okružnog načelstva. Oko podne stigli su i Kosta Pećanac i Vojinović.
O imenjače! Svi sokaci u Prokuplju su u komitskim rukama.
Šta radite, vreto Vojinoviću? Sam je rekao da stvar još nije dozrela. Ovim ćemo sami sebi grob iskopati. Ajde, obustavite sve napade i prekinite paljbu.
Utišaj se, Milovanoviću. Nisi ti za vođu ustanka. Ti si jedan strašljivac i oklevalo. I trebalo je ti za pisara da ideš, a ne komitski vojvoda da budeš.
Slušaj ti.
Ni sam kralj ne može da zaustavi ono što je narod započeo i što hoće. Čekam te u Nišu. Vojvodo.
Kosta Vojinović Kosovac, a young and unshakable Serbian patriot, a second lieutenant in the Serbian Army Reserve, was remembered as the bravest hero of the Toplica uprising.
Pesnik Vojislav Ilić Mlađi je pisao: u najstrašnijem času iskušenja, kad život groznim mučilištem posta, ko živi izraz srpskog ogorčenja, iskrsnu vitez, Vojinović Kosta.
In occupied Serbia, the people saw him as the avenger of the oppressed and the tormented, and the harbinger of the liberation that must be won. The warrior attitude and courage of Kosta Vojinović are in the footsteps of the glorious deeds of the mythologized Serbian heroes who laid down their lives for the fatherland.
On sam bio je beskompromisan borac za slobodu, nesvakidašnji junak i čovjek sa veoma razvijenom svešću o potrebi služenju opštoj stvari. Bio je jedan od najboljih komandanata, a njegov odred bio je najelitnija jedinica srpske gerile u Velikom ratu, stalno na udaru protivniku.
Lieutenant Kosta Milovanović Pećanac was 13 years older than Kosta Vojinović.
Iskusan i oprezan, prekaljen u mnogim komitskim borbama, bio je individualac, nedorastao da komanduje većim jedinicama, a naročito neorganizovanim ustankom na okupiranoj teritoriji. Što zbog toga što je nastojao da sledi smernice vrhovne komande, što zbog svog proračunatog karaktera, često je oklevao i odlagao napade četničkih jedinica. Posle sloma ustanka povukao se u planine. I sredinom maja 1917. godine sa oko 300 četnika izvršio je gerilski upad na bugarsku teritoriju. Četnici su stigli sve do Bosiljgrada, koji je ostao u plamenu.
Ono što je odlikovalo Kostu Pećanca u gerilskim borbama jeste promišljenost, jeste lukavstvo, jeste prvenstveno spremnost da se skloni, da udari iznenada i da se potom povuče.
Despite the initial successes, the uprising was short-lived. After 1 month of freedom, the enemy increased the pressure. With much greater superiority in manpower, the enemy regained almost all the previously lost territories and settlements. The rebels were beginning to waver. Stretched along the long front line, the rebels could not provide any firmer resistance, and a decisive battle never happened, thanks to Kosta Pećanac's order to withdraw. On March 14th, the Central Powers captured Prokuplje, the capital of the Free Territory, without a fight. In the second half of March, the people's resistance ceased. Left to themselves, exhausted and outnumbered, the rebels pulled back like a low tide. But that was not the end of it. The occupying forces carried out brutal reprisals over the rebellious population in the territory of the uprising.
Bugarski premijer Vasil Radoslavov govorio je da će ustanak biti ugušen bezobzirno i da će nastati takav krvavi sud kakav još nije viđen u današnje vreme. U kaznenoj ekspediciji izvršeni su ratni zločini nad civilnim stanovništvom i naneta ogromna materijalna šteta.
Anketni odbor koji je ustanovljen 1919. godine utvrdio je da je u toku ustanka i posle ustanka ubijeno 8767 osoba u tri okruga, znači Vranjski, Niški i Toplički, a da je u isto vreme 43541 objekat uništen. To su egzaktni podaci koji mogu da se upoređuju sa onim savremenim procenama koje su nastale u toku svetskog rata, koje govore o 20.000 ubijenog stanovništva i ustanika na celom širem području koji je obuhvaćen ustankom i akcijama neprijatelja.
Intimidated by terror of retaliation and lured by promises of financial rewards and amnesty, individuals became enemy informants, betraying their one-time comrades. However, despite the developed intelligence and snitch network and the reinforcements deployed, the occupying forces failed to completely destroy the Komitar troops. Though weakened, they withdrew to the mountains and met the final liberation of Serbia.
Posle ugušenja masovne faze ustanka, ostalo je u šumama i planinama oko 2600 ustanika i kompletno vođstvo ustanka. Bugari u tom trenutku primenjuju novu taktiku, uključuju specijalne jedinice, poterna odelenja od bivših komita i nekako drže po strani ovu regularnu vojsku. Međutim, moramo da kažemo da ni ta akcija ne bi bila toliko uspešna da nije bilo domaćih saradnika okupatora, izdajica, pa čak i onih dojučerašnjih komita koje su učestvovale i u komitskoj i ustaničkoj akciji.
Otkazivali su me imućni građani, seljani, a siromašni izlazili su nam u susret i čuvali me.
Četnički odred Vojvode Kosovca ostao je usamljen na bojištu. Jedna bugarska potera predvođena Srbima opkolila je šestoro četnika u Vodenici blizu Grgurske reke.
Do decembra 1917. godine Kosta Vojinović, iako ranjen, uspešno izbegava potere. U popodnevnim satima 23. decembra Vodenica u Grgurevačkom potoku je opkoljena. Vojinović je ispunio ono što je poručivao neprijatelju. Živ se ne predajem. Nije me briga koliko vas je. Samo je važno gde ste.
Meren principima nauke o ratnoj veštini, Toplički ustanak predstavlja vojnički neuspeh. Podignut je prerano i daleko od zvanične linije fronta. U završnoj godini rata, srpska vrhovna komanda nije mogla da računa na udare ustaničkih odreda u pozadini neprijatelja i time obezbedi brži prodor srpskih trupa u otadžbinu.
Istoričar prvenstveno zaključuje na osnovu izvora prvog reda, odnosno podataka koje su ostavili savremenici i učesnici ustanka. Iz toga se logično izvlači zaključak da je srpski narod bio prinuđen na jedan revolt i bunt zbog ponašanja okupacionih organa vlasti.
The Toplitsa uprising spawned a plejad of gigantic heroes, more willing and bolder than Pechanets. These were Uroš Kostić Rudinac, Jovan Radović, Milinko and Toško Vlahović, Pop Mita Komita, Dimitrije Begović, Vučko Pantić and others. They had no commanding experience with large military units. They were just brave men of the people, willing to sacrifice both their own lives and those of their families for freedom and fatherland. Remembered for participating in the battles are Rosa Pantić, Rizna Radović, Stanka Petrović Dimić, Jelena Šaulić, and other known and unknown heroines. Their names live throughout time.
U kontekstu zbivanja Prvog svjetskog rata, Toplički ustanak, iako donekle uporediv sa sličnim zbivanjima u Irskoj ili na Bliskom istoku, koji su u popularnoj kulturi savremenog doba predstavljeni romantično i herojski, predstavlja potpuno zasebnu ravan. Nigde, osim na jugu Srbije, narod nije u tako velikoj meri, spontano i bez poticaja sa strane, ustao protiv okupatora, uprkos ili u inat merama koje su ti zavojevači nastojali da sprovedu. I nigde nije za izvojevanje sobstvene slobode, iako kratkotrajne, bio tako surovo kažnjen. U tome je jedinstvenost, značaj i veličina Topličkog ustanka.
Srpski narod robovao je 500 godina, pa je opet samostalan postao. Pa još toliko neka robu ipak ne može i ne sme izgubiti nadu da će skoro biti slobodan. I dokle god ne postanemo slobodni, dotle neće prestati da bude ljudi koji će ići narodom i opominjati isti da je vreme da se sami oslobode, kao što su naši stari govorili. Pa ako ne bude Vojnovića, bit će drugih.